Hello student, very good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think we were discussing about how to solve problem based on IR spectroscopy. There is a one formulated very specifically formulated formula used for solving the problem by using as IR spectroscopy. Now the another question may appear in exam. The question may be like the how will you distinguish the following pair by IR spectroscopy. As we know that spectroscopy means the interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter is known as a spectroscopy, and IR is generally provide the information about the functional group. There are different functional group present in the organic compound and specific functional group gives the appearance of particular functional group has one particular range of absorption or that particular stretching frequency, and by knowing that stretching frequency we can immediately come to know that the organic chemistry specifically come to know that what kind of the functional group present in the given compound, given organic compound. Because let us see, for example, carbonyl group. The carbonyl group, the appearance of absorption peak or the band or the signal around 1700 per centimeter, which has definite shape and size, and when it either sometime it is the value IR frequency value may be either increase or decrease depending upon the following factor involved in it, such as inductive effect, resonance effect, hydrogen bonding, steric effect. And if such effects are present, the normal value of that IR stretching frequency slightly shifted either higher or lower depending upon which factor involving it in it. So let's begin with the question once again. In what respect, let's see here, in what respect the IR spectra, in what respect the IR spectra of the following pairs of organic compounds compounds, organic compounds differ from each other, differ from each other, differ from each other, do not consider fingerprint region, do not consider fingerprint region, fingerprint region. And number one is given, suppose here phenyl acetic acid and methyl benzoate, phenyl acetic acid and methyl benzoate, that's the pair is given. If you read this question carefully, see here, in what respect the IR spectra of the following pairs of organic compounds differ from each other, do not consider fingerprint region. And as we know that fingerprint region is a very complex region where the two sample, for the comparison of the two sample, if they are identical, then there, then and then, this region is very useful. But as far as ordinary functional groups are considered, this fingerprint region is not used. The fingerprint region used only for the comparison of the sample. Those are identical sample. Otherwise, these fingerprint, they are specifically mentioned here. Do not consider the fingerprint region. Now, what do you understand here from this question? In what respect the IR spectra of the following pairs, look at here, pairs, following pairs of organic compound differ from each other. In other way round, this question may appear in the exam like this, or such as, how will you differentiate, or how will you differ, or how will you distinguish the following pair by IR spectroscopy. This is a modified nature of question may appear in an exam. Let's see once again, how will you distinguish the following pair by IR spectroscopy? And as we know that IR spectroscopy is used to by knowing their IR bands, IR peaks or IR absorption signals, because particular functional group has particular IR or group frequency, stretching frequencies. And here, what is given? Phenyl acetic acid and the methyl benzoate. First of all, you should know the structure of the organic compound, then and then you can able to answer the question. Otherwise, if you are not knowing, if you are unable to draw the structure of phenyl acetic acid and the methyl benzoate, then rest of the thing is becoming difficult and difficult. Here, most of you might be knowing the structure of phenyl acetic acid and the methyl benzoate. I am assuming that All of you are knowing the structure of phenylacetic acid and the methyl benzoate. Everybody knows that the structure of acetic acid. Here, the additional part is phenyl, means that aromatic part is. If you remember the structure of acetic acid, CH3 C double bond OH, right? From methyl group, there are three hydrogen attached to that methyl group. One of the hydrogen atom replaced by methyl group, that structure becomes as a phenylacetic acid. Got it? Let's see here. This is a, I am writing CH2 C double bond O and OH, right? This is a structure. If CH3 is there, that becomes as acetic acid. But specifically, purposely, I have written the structure CH2 C double bond OH. And now, what I am going to do here, well, I am replacing one of the hydrogen atom by this group. You know that this group is nothing but as a phenyl group, right? Or either you can show like this, or you can show alternative double bond in the ring, that is a phenyl ring. And another one is a methyl benzoate. Benz indicate as a benzyl, and OAT indicate as a ester, and methyl, as we know that the structure of the another compound is this one. Let's see here, C double bond O, then O, and here you can write as a CH3. This is the structure of methyl benzoate. Once you draw the correct structure, then half of the work is finished here or over here. Now, these are the two different compound, is a pair of the organic compound, and when you put this compound, few milligram of the sample of phenylacetic acid, pure compound, if you introduce the IR and then it provide the spectra. And if you observe that spectra carefully, there are different signals or the bands. And as we know that the bands are due to the particular stretching frequency of that particular functional group. If you see here is an aromatic compound is present. Here also has an aromatic compound. Both the compound compare, run the IR spectra of methyl acetic acid and the separately, and the another one methyl benzoate separately, and observe those two spectra. Compare these two spectra and identify the prominent peak. The prominent peak or the important peak observed in those two separate spectra. Here, the common peak are observed in those spectra, the peak around 1500 to 1600 per centimeter. Here also, in this spectra also, 1500 to 1600 per centimeter. Why these band appear in both the spectra, which clearly indicate that there is a carbon-carbon double bond of aromatic compound. It proves that there will be a aromatic compound in the both the compounds. That confirm that both compound are the aromatic in nature because the prominent peak appear around 1500 to 1600 per centimeter, clearly indicate that the presence of carbon-carbon double bond of aromatic or the due to the phenyl ring or the benzene ring. Now, but both are there, both are producing those peak, recognizable peak. From that we can say that there is a aromatic compound, that's it. But what is that? How will you distinguish the following pair by IR spectroscopy? Or in what respect the IR spectra of the following pairs of organic compound differ from each other? So if you see here in this compound, here also has a carbonyl group, here also has a carbonyl group, and as we know that carbonyl group, due to the presence of carbonyl group, gives strong and the definite shape, strong peak appear around here one, which is near about 1710 per centimeter due to the carbonyl group, and another peak in methyl benzoate due to the carbonyl group, the peak appear around is 1730 per centimeter, and which is a characteristic of that ester. Look at here, both the compound containing as a carbonyl group, but one appear around 1710 and one around 1730 per centimeter. These bands are slightly lower than the normal value of that carbonyl carbon, and in another structure the IR value is a slightly greater than the normal value of that carbonyl carbon. There are different factors which affect the IR frequencies. Normal ester, if present in the compound, the carbonyl carbon of the ester group normal value around 1738, which is given in the reference book like as a Pavia, or at a TY BSc level we are generally considering the round figure 1714 per centimeter due to the presence of carbonyl group, and that carbonyl group has this type of the strong and the sharp peak, which has the shape and size is very fixed, it is not changed at all. And by the organic chemist immediately recognizing by looking its shape and size. So here also, but slightly shifted here around 1720 and 1730, and as I already told you that there are different factors which affect the IR frequency of that particular functional group. Specifically in these two structure, the common functional group appear or has carbonyl group, but those carbonyl group one appear around 1710 and one around 1730 suggests that there is a carbonyl group. That now the most prominent peak is appear here because you are nearer to the answer, but here the prominent peak
Due to the OH stretching frequency around 2500 to 3600 per centimeter strong and the broad peak appear around here, as we know that such type of the broad peak may appear here, the broad and the strong peak clearly suggests that there is a hydroxy group is present, and as we know that the broad peak is appear due to the hydrogen bonding, and we also know that there are two kind of the hydrogen bonding. One is a intramolecular hydrogen bonding and another one is a intermolecular hydrogen bonding. You also know that intermolecular hydrogen bonding means the hydrogen bonding occur between two, maybe same atom or different at, maybe same molecule or two same molecule or two different molecule. Or intramolecular hydrogen bonding means what? The hydrogen bonding occur within the molecule, and if both the both kind of the hydrogen bondings are present, they always produce such a type of the strong and the broad peak. So here OH, and in phenyl acetic acid the appearance of peak around 2500 per 2500 to 3600 per centimeter due to the OH stretching frequency, and which is absent in the second spectra in a methyl benzoate. In the methyl benzoate these peak were absent. These 2500 to 3600 per centimeter, these band is absent in the methyl benzoate. Instead the new band is appear around one, or very typical band appear around 1100 per centimeter, which is a indication of presence of CO stretching frequency, ester stretching frequency, and in this way we can easily distinguish these kind of the pairs by just mentioning there what type of the functional groups are present there, and just write its IR values, and that's it. So in this way we can easily distinguish the pairs of the following molecules. Okay, now let us look at second type of the second pair. Now second pair will be this one. Let's see what is it. Second one will be this one, benzyl alcohol and benzaldehyde. Benzyl alcohol, which is written benzyl alcohol and benzaldehyde. Benzyl alcohol and benzaldehyde, two names are given. One is the benzyl alcohol, another one is the benzaldehyde. As I already told you that you are the organic chemist, you must know the structure of these common molecules. Because if you are not knowing the structure of this type of the common molecule, then it's very difficult to answer such type of the questions. So let me
draw the structure of benzyl alcohol. Benz indicate as there will be the benzene moiety present over there. Benzyl alcohol CH2 then OH. This is the structure of benzyl alcohol. Now you know that the structure of benzaldehyde. While studying, they see double bond O and H. Now if you observe these two structures carefully, structure number one and that is the structure number second, the common appearance of a band around 1500 to 1600 per centimeter, which is we know that due to the carbon-carbon double bond of aromatic compound, that is the prominent peak suggests that there is a aromatic moiety is present in both the spectra. Look at here, we have taken as a spectra for benzyl alcohol and the benzaldehyde. Now we are comparing these two spectra and trying to distinguish these two molecules from each other. Now both the common means it prove that both the compound containing as a benzyl moiety. Now the another prominent peak appear around here is a 3200 to 3600 per centimeter. The band, the IR absorption band around 3200 to 36 per centimeter strong and the broad band clearly suggests that there is a hydroxyl group is present, and that hydroxyl group due to the stretching, OH stretching frequency. Now if you see over here, due to the carbonyl group, as we know that the band appear around 1700 and 10 per centimeter, which is one of the very prominent important peak in IR, which has definite shape and size, very recognizable band appear in the IR. And if aldehyde is there, the typical band appear around 2700 to 2900 per centimeter, 2700 to 2900 per centimeter, which clearly indicate that the aldehyde group is present. And as we know that aldehyde group is always present at the end of the organic compound. So in this way we can clearly distinguish over here the band around 3200 to 3600 per centimeter, which is absent in the benzaldehyde, and benzaldehyde gives the prominent peak one at 1710 per centimeter due to the carbonyl stretching frequency, whereas another peak appear around 2700, 2700 to 2900 per centimeter, clearly indicate presence of aldehyde group in the organic compounds. So in this way we can distinguish these two structures from each other by IR spectroscopy. Now let us move on to the next pair, that is a metacresol and anisol. Third one, let us look at here, metacresol and the anisol. Metacresol and the anisol. Let's see here, third point, metacresol, metacresol and anisol. So again as usual, you should know the structure of organic compound. If you know the structure of these common organic compound, then it's very easy, because that IR values of that particular functional group, that tracing frequencies are given at the end of the question paper. There is a separate charts are provided, and that values from that you can easily find out. But the structure is a very, very essential to know metacrysal. Let me draw the structure of metacrysal. Is this one. Here is a methyl group, and at meta position there is a OH. This is the structure of metacrysal, now anisol. And let's see the structure of, you might be knowing the structure of phenol is OH. That hydrogen atom get replaced by the methyl group, so that will be the structure of anisol. Metacrysal and the anisol, they are the isomers of each other. What kind of the isomer they are? They are the functional group isomers. One containing as a hydroxyl group, another containing as a ester group. It is a mixed ether. It will be the phenolic compound. Now once again, there is aromatic compound, and everybody knows that the common peak appear around 1500 to 1600 per centimeter due to the aromatic compound. Here also 1500 to 1600 per centimeter due to the carbon-carbon double bond, which suggests that there is a presence of aromatic compound. Now the distinct band here, due to the OH tracing frequency 3200 to 3600 per centimeter, this suggests that the band, the IR absorption band around or the near 3200 to 3600 per centimeter, due to the presence of OH tracing frequency, which is absent in the anisole. The anisole, which gives the typical peak around 1100 per centimeter, which is the characteristic of ester linkage, very typical peak appear. The IR absorption band around 1100 per centimeter suggests that the presence of ether in the organic compound. So in this way, you can easily distinguish the pairs by using IR spectroscopy. Now let us look at one more example over here, which can be distinguished. Let us see fourth one, that is a paramethyl benzaldehyde. Here is a paramethyl benzaldehyde, paramethyl benzaldehyde and acetophenone. Acetophenone, paramethyl benzaldehyde and the acetophenone. Once again, you should know the structure of paramethyl benzaldehyde. The structure of paramethyl benzaldehyde is this one. Here I am writing as a methyl group. At exactly para position, there will be the aldehyde group. And you know that the name of that, most of you might be knowing the structure of acetophenone will be this one. This is a structure of acetophenone. Now, and you can, by using as a IR spectroscopy, you can easily distinguish between aldehyde and the ketone. Here once again, the aromatic compound which produce the band around 1500 to 1600 per centimeter. In this another spectra also, you can observe the peak around 1500 to 1600 per centimeter due to the presence of aromatic compound. Now here the carbonyl group, the peak appear around is 1710 per centimeter, and another prominent peak appear around 2700 to 2900 per centimeter, which suggests that there is an aldehyde group is present, and this carbonyl group, which is near about 1700 per centimeter. As I already told you that the shape and size of that carbonyl group is very, very recognizable, and that's why the organic chemist immediately, by looking at the spectra within the fraction of second, they come to know that whether there is a carbonyl group is present or not. In that way, they are analyzing or interpreting the IR spectra and finding what type of the functional groups are present over here. So if you see over there, the IR absorption band around 1710 per centimeter. In addition to that, the IR absorption band around 2700 to 2900 per centimeter, 2900 to 2700 per centimeter, clearly suggests that there is aldehyde group is present. And as we know that aldehyde group is always present at the end of the organic compound. In the second structure, if you observe carefully, there is a carbonyl group is present, and which the IR absorption band appear around 1700 per centimeter, indicate the presence of carbonyl group, which is the normal value of that ketone is, saturated ketone is found nearly 1715 per centimeter. Here is a slightly less due to the carbonyl group in the conjugation, and that's why the value is appear around 1700 per centimeter in an acetophenol. I think with this we have discussed how to distinguish the pairs of the organic compound by using IR spectroscopy. I think with this, let us stop today here. Remaining we will see in the next lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.